Welcome back. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to transfer data from a Samsung Galaxy phone to your new one using Smart Switch. I'm formatting this video to be as if you've just got your new phone, so we'll be starting from the very beginning. I've also included a section on how to transfer data after you've already set up your phone, so feel free to use the chapters to skip to the sections that are most relevant to you. Remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe if the video helps. Let's get into the method. There's a few things to mention before we get started with the switch. First, it's important to talk about the SIM card. There seems to be mixed opinions on whether you should move it before or after the switch. It shouldn't affect the transfer in any way, and I've already moved the SIM over before powering on the new phone for the first time. Of course, turn off your old phone before removing the SIM card. The switch may bring data off your microSD card if you have one and put it onto the internal storage of your new phone. If you don't want it to do this, you could remove the SD card for now, and then insert it into your new phone after the switch. Again, make sure your devices are off when you do this. Another thing to mention is that this won't delete the data on your old phone. That phone will still work as normal with your files and apps. The only difference will be that because it doesn't have a SIM, no cellular functions will work, but it will still have Wi-Fi for us to be able to switch. You are able to transfer after setting up, and this means that if any problems occur during the transfer, or if any apps or data don't transfer fully, you can try the transfer again at a later time. Finally, make sure both your phones have enough battery power to be able to complete the transfer, and I recommend having the charging cable ready and even plugged in on your old phone, just in case. Let's get started with the transfer. First, we need to focus on your new device and power it on for the first time. We need to follow the setup process and get into the phone before we can start transferring data, if you haven't done this already. Power it on, and I'll quickly go through some of the setup process, but it should be fairly simple for you to follow the instructions on the screen. Click the card on screen now if you want to watch a more detailed setup video. Now you'll need to choose a language, read terms, and choose whether or not you want to opt into any data collections. Keep an eye out for these if you don't want to. After this, you should get to a page that allows you to get information from your old phone. This page is called Setup Using Another Device. This isn't the full data transfer yet, but doing this will allow you to save time. Tap on Galaxy or Android device, and then scan the QR code shown on your new phone with your old one. You can do this in the camera app. Follow the link with Google if you can, and it should say connecting. You'll need to verify your identity next on your old device by using your PIN or biometrics. After this, your Google account and even Wi-Fi data will be transferred to your new phone, so you shouldn't need to log in or connect to your Wi-Fi network. All of this is automatic. Finally, for this section, you may need to restart your new phone by tapping on the blue button. Eventually, you'll get to a screen that asks if you want to copy apps and data from your Android device. Make sure you tap on the blue Next button here, and look out for any Allow buttons or OK buttons on one or both of the phones if it asks you at any stage. You need to allow permissions in order to transfer the data. If you've already set up your device, you can still transfer your data from your old phone. Open Settings on both of your phones, and scroll down and choose Accounts and Backup. Now choose Smart Switch on your old phone, and then bring data from old device on your new phone in the Smart Switch section. You now need to choose the relevant option on both of your phones. This means choose Send Data on your old phone, and Receive Data on your new phone. The process should now be identical whether you're setting up your device for the first time or not, so everyone can follow from here to transfer your data. You might need to choose a source for the data transfer on your new phone, so tap on Galaxy and Android. Now we need to choose a connection type for the transfer. You will have the option of choosing wireless transfer or by using a cable. Tap on the option you want on one or both of your phones, and remember to choose the same option on both if you have that. Transferring over Wi-Fi will take longer, so we'll be using the cable. I'm using a USB-C to USB-C cable for this, and they just need to be inserted into each of the charging ports. Your new device will search for data to transfer, and then present you with the options of what you can bring. You can choose everything if you want, that's what we'll be doing, but if you tap on Custom and then Next, you can choose individual categories to be transferred. Take your time with this and make sure you choose to bring everything you want to. Tap on Next and now you might see some apps that can't bring messaging data. WhatsApp is a common one and you'll need to backup chats on that app, which you can do by selecting it and then by creating a backup. If you are transferring WhatsApp data, then click the card or click the link in the description to watch a helpful video showing you how to do that. You can follow that method after you tap on WhatsApp, as it will open the app on your old phone. And for any other apps here, I'd recommend researching their own methods. Essentially, all you need to do is create a recent backup. Click on Next and the data transfer should begin. This could take a while depending on the data being transferred and your Wi-Fi speed. Allow it to complete, however, if you are setting up your device for the first time, you should be allowed to complete the setup process while data is being transferred. There won't be too many steps left. These include turning on or turning off backups, and when you get to signing into or creating a Samsung account, look out for the skip button, as you can do this later if you want to. Also remember to keep an eye out to opt out from any data collections if you don't want that. There will also be a section on installing recommended apps. These are not related to the transfer and are just apps that you might like. You can uncheck the box next to these to not install them. Once you've followed the remaining setup steps and completed the setup, you should load up your phone and have all your data on it. This includes things like your wallpaper and home screen layout, so your device should look identical to your old one. Now I'd recommend checking that everything has copied over before you delete the contents of your old phone, if you choose to do that in the future. You can always move files and photos manually via the internet or a PC later, as the data on your old phone will not be deleted as mentioned at the start. If some apps seem to be greyed out, they might be installing, so check by swiping down from the top of the screen to see your notifications. Allow these to download and install, and it might take a while depending on how many apps need to be installed. If for some reason the transfer didn't take everything, you can always try again using the method shown earlier on how to use Smart Switch once you've already set up your device. Remember that some of the apps on your device might require sign-ins again, and some will have their own way of transferring data and backups, so check for the method for each of the apps you own if their data wasn't transferred within the app. That's how to transfer data from a Samsung Galaxy phone to your new one using Smart Switch. Click or tap the card on screen now to watch a video of mine showing you 10 easy ways to speed up your Android phone. If you have any questions, then let me know in the comments below, and if you did find today's video helpful, remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe for more tips in the future. Be sure to stick around to see some of my other videos that you might be interested in. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in another video.